Next, I'd like to invite Todd Stiefel. Todd has helped to develop this campaign, and his Stiefel Freethought Foundation is the largest financial donor to the campaign with a contribution of $150,000. Todd's an activist in this movement, is on the advisory board of the American Humanist Association, and helps with other groups, including the Secular Student Alliance, American Atheists, and Secular Coalition for America.
Good morning. For millennia, the Bible and Quran have been the foundations of moral authority and claimed ethical superiority for religious fundamentalists. Until now, they expected a reference to their scripture was sufficient to unquestioningly settle a moral debate. That time is over. Unfortunately for fundamentalists, their scriptural foundation is faulty and collapsing under the weight of a mix of both admirable and corrupt ethical lessons. I would like to present two quotes to you to compare. First, they must bear their guilt because they have rebelled against their God. They will fall by the sword. Their little ones will be dashed to the ground. Their pregnant women will be ripped open. Second, I will cast terror into the hearts of those who disbelieve. Therefore, strike off their heads and strike off every fingertip of them. Which of these is from the Quran, and which is from the Bible? It's hard to tell. Both are in the context of war with an enemy of a different religion, and both actually advocate genocide and mutilation. The first is the Bible, Hosea 13:16. The second is the Quran, 8:12. The question is, does either quote present a useful moral lesson? Does either enrich our lives with wisdom, or do they lead to fear and tyranny? Regardless of the context of the horrors of war, is there ever a situation where chopping off the heads and fingers of people, or mutilating pregnant women and killing children is acceptable, even if they are your enemy? Of course not. The modern civilized world rejects such brutality. Thousands of years ago, though, these ethics were the best our primitive ancestors had in the ancient deserts of the world. Their barbaric moral codes were encoded into scripture, and these scriptures read the exact same today as they did then. For example, in the Bible continues sanctioning and encouraging genocide, slavery, infanticide, fear, intolerance, hate, ignorance, inequity for women, and even rape. If you do not believe this, stop ignoring the pastor and actually read the Bible. It's all in there. Fortunately, times have changed. Ethics have evolved. Religious and secular Americans both now reject such evil. Scripture cannot change. It is unable to learn from the ills of history, such as wars, terrorism, crusades, inquisitions, or even slave labor. Much scripture has become outdated, but humanity has learned. Most of us, religious or not, ignore the immoral aspects of scripture and pretend it is simply not there. Today, the secular values of humanists are shared by most religious Americans. Humanists value love. We value peace, equality. We value integrity and freedom. Most religious Americans value these things as well. The key exceptions in America are the religious fundamentalists of the religious right. These biblical Christian fundamentalists have not learned from history. Their hate-based morals are stuck in antiquity. These fundamentalists preach inequality for gay people and justify it with Bible quotes such as, "If a man lies with a man as one lies with a woman, both of them have done what is detestable. They must be put to death. Their blood will be on their own hands." Leviticus 20:24. Yet, the Bible also says, "Now kill all the boys and kill every woman who has slept with a man, but save for yourselves every girl who has never slept with a man." That is Numbers 31:17-18. Let me repeat that. "Now kill all the boys and kill every woman who has slept with a man, but save for yourselves every girl who has never slept with a man." If we should use law to repress gay Americans because the Bible says so, does this mean we should legalize virgin sex slavery because the Bible also sanctions this, so long as they are the daughters of your enemy and not your own daughters? Of course not. Both of these biblical verses are morally corrupt. We must denounce politicians that contend U.S. law should be based on the Bible and the Ten Commandments. It is not based on these and should never be. Our founding fathers created a secular democracy, not a Christian theocracy. For example, not a single one of the Ten Commandments can be found in the United States Constitution. The Fourth Commandment states that we must remember the Sabbath day and keep it holy. The Bible goes on to say what the punishment for this is in Exodus 31:15. "For 6 days work is to be done, but the seventh day is a Sabbath of rest, holy to the Lord. Whoever does any work on the Sabbath day must be put to death." If we base our laws on the Ten Commandments, we will be required to institute the death penalty for people doing yard work or checking their emails on a Saturday. This would be a horrific restriction on freedom. The Ten Commandments and their punishments are inherently un-American. There is much noise being made today in opposition to the use of Sharia law in the United States. Biblical law is equally as nefarious as Sharia law. We call on Americans and humanists of all stripes to stand against the religious fundamentalists, to stand against the religious right. They claim to speak for all American Christians. They do not. And they do not speak for humanists either. The values of mainstream American Christians are more aligned with humanist values than the malevolent values of the religious right. You may ask, who are humanists to question scripture? Just like you, we are everyday Americans who have the right to question anything that we read. We are atheists without a belief in any gods that do believe in kindness over bigotry, freedom over slavery. We believe in science over ignorance, reason over fear, peace over war, and love over hate. In sum, we are humanists, and you might be too. Thank you.